What is your name?
My name is Trisha Jha. You can call me Trisha.
Where are you from?
I am from Noida, Delhi NCR.
Do you work or are you a student?
As of now, I'm a student. I am preparing to go to UK to pursue my master's.
Do you live in an apartment or a house?
I live in an apartment. There are around 3,000 families that live together in the society.
Do you like it?
I actually love it here. Earlier, when I used to live in an independent flat, in an independent house, it used to be more difficult to interact with people. However, in our society, we have many functions that take place over the years. So we are able to come together for different events.
Are you proud of your country?
I'm absolutely proud of my country. I think that my country is a place where all of us mostly live with harmony. And at times, whenever there is an issue, we come together to solve it as one.
What area of your country do you like the most?
Well, I like Northeast the most. I believe it is beautiful and I enjoy Northeastern food a lot.
Where would you prefer to live in your country?
Well, as I said, I love Northeast and I would definitely want to settle down in Northeast, somewhere around Sikkim, I would say.
Why?
I believe that Sikkim is a very distinct state. It has a beautiful language, people wear beautiful attires, and I especially enjoy dim sums. So I think that is one place I would definitely want to settle in.
Okay, let's talk about picnics. Do you like picnics?
Well, yes, I do like picnics. However, I'm not able to go to enjoy those picnics as often as I would like to, considering there are not too many spots, not as many picnic spots around where I live.
How often do you go for a picnic these days?
Well, since the last 2 years, it has been difficult to arrange a picnic. But when things were normal, I would occasionally go for a picnic around twice a year.
Where do people in your country usually go for a picnic and why?
Okay. In my country, people mostly go for picnics around parks, around the lake, or even on a hill station.
Okay, let's talk about pets. Do you like pets?
I like pets, but I am not the most comfortable around them.
Why so?
That's mostly because I'm afraid to come close to them. I have a fear of dogs. I know that's a little awkward, but I'm not the most comfortable around them.
Do you have a pet?
No, I don't have a pet.
Do you think pets can be kept at home?
Well, some pets can be kept at home. Since time immemorial, people have kept, dogs and cats and small fishes as pets.
Okay, let's talk about driving. Do you like driving a car?
Well, I don't know how to drive, but if I would learn to drive, I think I would definitely enjoy it. But that's something I need to look into.
Do you like long car trips?
Definitely. I remember going on a lot of them when I was younger. But since one has to study a lot these days, so I stay mostly indoors.
What was your longest trip?
My longest trip was from Delhi to Himachal Pradesh. It happened around 4 to 5 years back. We took a travel bus from Delhi and we went through Punjab and then Uttarakhand and then straight to Himachal Pradesh.
Did you go by yourself or with friends?
Well, I went with my family. We're a family of around 10 people. So all of us went together for that trip.
Do you remember people's names when you meet them?
I'm good with names and phone numbers. And when I meet them, I make sure that I remember the names for the later time week.
How do you remember them?
Well, I would say I'm kind of good with it. So at times when I hear somebody's names, I often ask what does it mean? So that is how I sometimes remember their names.
How do you feel when others don't remember your name?
Well, I definitely feel disappointed, considering that I'm somebody who's very particular about remembering people's names. So I definitely feel disappointed.
Are you an energetic person?
I like to believe so. I've always been interested in dance and drama, and I've also taken part in a couple of sports activities like tennis and football. So yes, I would like to consider myself as an energetic person.
Do you think energetic person are successful?
Well, that depends, but in most case scenarios, I would assume that one needs to be energetic both physically and mentally in order to succeed in life.
Do you think people in physically hard jobs should be paid more?
Well, yes. There are a lot of dangers attached to certain professions. So that does come with a lot of hardship that might lead to a couple of problems. And to overcome those, I think one needs to be paid well.
Do you think we need mentally energetic person now more than in the past? And why?
Well, definitely, yes. In today's day and age, working hours are such, there's so much of competition out there. And in order to succeed and in order to have people who will motivate the company or an organization to do better, I think we definitely need people to be strengthened from their minds.
All right, now in this part two, I will give you your 2-minute topic. You will have 1 minute to prepare and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. Okay?
All right.
Your topic is describe a short trip you often take that you don't like. Where you go, when you go, why you go there, and explain why you don't like this trip.
For the 3 years of my life, I had to travel to my college 6 days a week. And for that, I took a metro every day. The distance from where I live to my university was around 1 hour and 25 minutes. Out of which 25 minutes were spent on auto rickshaw and 1 hour was spent on metro. The reason why I did not enjoy traveling from metro and metro was basically because it was a long journey. It was tedious to travel every day for approximately 1.5 hours, especially when I was unable to find seats. Considering we're a populated country, it's very difficult to find a seat at any hour of the day. Especially when somebody is woken up at 6 in the morning or 7 in the morning, and then to take a metro at 8, it was definitely troublesome. But despite of all those hurdles, I managed to go to my college for at least 5 days out of 6. And I would like to thank my parents for that, considering they always boosted my energy. They told me that it's important to go to college. So even though it is a difficult journey, you must go. Which is why even though it was not the most enjoyable journey, I still undertook it for 3 long years. And if I would have had the chance to travel from any other means of transport, I would not exactly make any changes in that, considering that even though I did not enjoy traveling, it definitely taught me a lot of things. I consider myself as a more adjusting person. I think that circumstances are not always how we want them to be. And one definitely must not think that just because things are not right for you or things are not fruitful for you, you should give up. You should definitely strive for excellence. Like I said, the reason why I did not like traveling from metro is because it was difficult to find seats. It was difficult to, you know, talk on the phone or even read a book in peace, considering that there were so many people around me. And sometimes being girls, one is often subjected to some sort of the other of harassment or eve teasing, I would say. So that is one thing that is not the best when it comes to traveling in crowded places, and even metro for that example.
Okay, does anyone else take this trip with you or took this trip with you?
Well, a number of times my best friend took this trip with me. But since she was in a different department, we did not have the same timings. But whenever our timings clashed, we would take this trip together.
All right, in this part three, I will ask you a few questions related to this topic.
All right.
Do people from your country like to travel abroad and why?
People in my country definitely love to travel abroad. We've been going to different countries over the world in high percentages every year. We've been contributing to the revenue of so many countries around us thanks to our traveling habits. Well, we travel for a number of reasons. It could be health-related issues, education, or just for leisure.
How do people travel long distances for work in your country?
People take cars, public transport like bus, auto rickshaws, and local trains.
Can you explain why some people go abroad to work?
Well, there can be a number of reasons why one decides to go abroad. It could be to earn better or better job opportunities, a better standard of living. Yeah, these are the reasons that I can think of.
What other reasons do people have to travel abroad?
It could be for health-related issues, better job opportunities, to get better education, or to meet family and friends.
When do they travel?
Well, that depends on their need, the season, wherein it's preferable to venture into these countries. For example, if I have to go to UK, I would preferably want to go at a time when weather is suitable according to my needs. So, yes.
Okay. How has travel changed compared to some decades ago?
Well, till a few decades ago, there were not many number of flights. People used to travel only for important purposes. But now people are more flexible when it comes to planning trips. One can even plan a short trip with their immediate friends and family. Now people are more relaxed, and now people want to have fun. And for that, people prefer traveling by flights. Even flight prices are cheap now, so people definitely prefer to travel more often than before and more comfortably than before.
All right, this is the end of your speaking test.
Thank you.
I would like to give you your feedback. You are very good, Trisha. You can easily score 7 to 7.5 in real exam. Okay?
All right.
But if you are targeting 8 or 9, you have to speak more with examples. In the follow-up, try to give more examples also, live examples. Like these days, people are traveling for fun. Earlier, they used to travel for work or studies or business purpose. But now, just for the exposure, just to see the places, okay, they travel often. Okay. And sometimes, even without reason, people are planning trips.
Mm-hmm.
Just for a change or just to rejuvenate themselves. Earlier, going for trips was a big thing. But now it's normal and people are traveling. Here you can even talk about, like, sadly from last 2 years, people are restricted to travel. Unnecessary travel is banned. Here you can talk about unnecessary travel. What is unnecessary travel? When you don't have any work or any purpose, but you are just going to another country or city.
For fun.
And that is now banned because of COVID. Okay. Otherwise, in other all questions, it was very good. You gave good answers. Okay. And in try to add examples in discussion. All the best. Good luck.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.